last option that I would like to present to you on how to prepare the file to be loaded into Blender is VMD, also known as Visual Molecular Dynamics. I've chosen that program because it's a freeware as well and readily available. I have the impression that especially the interface is a bit old-fashioned and it takes a bit of getting used to it, but it's actually quite powerful. So let's have a look to that. If you decided to start right away with that tutorial, I'm going to put our structure into a scene I previously prepared in the tutorial where we loaded our protein structure from Chimera. So if you would like to check back how that scene here is prepared with the wooden table and so on and so forth, please go back and check that tutorial. There's going to be a timestamp where the styling of the scene starts. Good, so let's see how we deal with VMD. So I already prepared one file. What you see here, and this is something that I would like to draw your attention to, if you followed the tutorial from Yasara already, the tip here is very similar. If you look closely, you see that my helixes, my beta sheets, and the loops have different colors of green. It is important that you assign different colors. I went for green because green is not part of the atom color code, so there is nothing green in there. There is a second thing that is a bit of a problem with in VMD in comparison to Yasara. If you look quite closely to the different elements, you see that there is a gradient between one secondary structure element to the other. So between, for example, the sheet here to the loop, there is a gradient. So the program is going to calculate colors in between here. And this is something that might cause a problem. And that's also the reason why I tried to stay with only shades of green, because the transition colors are not going to be something different, hopefully. But let's double check that when we load it into Blender, so it should be fine. So let's export the file now. The good thing is that there is an option to export the file as a wavefront object. The wavefront object, as I described in the tutorial for Yasara, is actually a perfect file because it saves the structural information, and there is an additional file written, which is the MTL file, that conserves the color information. And this is the file type that we are going to choose here as well. Just select the path where you would like your file to be saved and click Start Rendering. Then your file is generated and we can go right away into Blender and load it there. Loading is quite easy again. You just go to File, Import, and then say Wavefront Object. If this option is not available for you, go to Edit Preferences, Filter for Import and Export, and just look for the Wavefront option and just tick it. And then if you go back into the Import section, it's going to show up in your list. So select the Wavefront object, then go to the folder you saved your file to. Here you only need to select the object file. You don't need to select both files because they are linked automatically. And then just hit Import. Then it takes a couple of seconds and there is our molecule and it appears nicely with the colors that we actually selected in VMD. An additional thing that appears here as well are those arrows that normally indicate the axis in VMD. They are exported as well, but they are very easy to delete. And this is the first thing that we are going to do before we are going to take care of the coloring and the styling of our molecule. For that, I'm going to go into the solid mode, and deleting of that object need to be done now in the edit mode. Since everything is grouped into one object, we cannot select that thing separately. So we are going to leave the object mode, go into edit mode, and now you see everything is selected. By hitting Alt and A, everything is deselected. And now we only would like to select that part. I'm also going to hide our plane so that we see what is happening here. Selecting that part here is also quite easy. There is one thing you need to remember. Before selecting, you need to activate Toggle X-ray. If you don't do that and just select the vertices like this, you might run into a problem because everything, all the vertices that are covered by the parts of the structure are not selected. So it's very hard to select everything and you would have to reselect and delete and reselect and delete over and over again. And by activating Toggle X-ray, you see suddenly everything becomes transparent, and if you reselect, all of the vertices are selected. Make sure that you don't select anything from your structure and then just hit X and say delete vertices, and then the arrow is basically gone. And we can leave the edit mode again by just going back into the object mode. Now your structure looks a bit weird, so it looks a bit like semi-transparent, but that comes from the Toggle X-ray function. So if you deactivate again, we are back to our normal looks. So now let's take care about the colors. If you select your object and go into the material properties subtab, you can see a long list of different colors that are assigned to your object. Some of them are very obvious. The red one, for example, is quite obvious. That's oxygen. So we are going to rename it to oxygen. Also the blue one, that is very obvious as well. That's the nitrogen. Then we have a rather brownish version that seems to be our phosphate, but I'm not entirely sure, so I'm going to double check by just selecting the color and I'm going to change the color to something different. Of course, in order to see if the change becomes visible, we need to go into the rendered mode. And now I'm going to change it to a very bright yellow. And you see that this is actually now our phosphate. Let's change it to something else. Yeah, let's change it to pink so it becomes very obvious. So that would be phosphate. I'm going to change it back to yellow or orange because I would like to have it that way. If that tiny preview over there doesn't change immediately, just give it some time and you see now it switched basically to the color that you selected. The turquoise here seems to be carbon. And also here I'm going to double check and I'm going to make it white. Yeah, so those are my carbon atoms. So I have the atom types assigned and I'm going to just put all of them in a row. The rest of the elements, as you see here, are now assigned to the secondary structure. So that one seems to be everything related to helix. So I'm going to change that name to helix. Then we have twice approximately the same green. And I guess that one of those colors came from the error that we had before, because that was a very bright green. And that one should be actually the colors of the loops. I'm going to double check that. So that one is the colors of the loops. And then that one should be the colors of the sheet. So this is sheet. And nothing should have the very bright green color, so I'm going to delete that one. Now you see that we assigned different colors to the different elements of our structure, and you have total control over how the structure should look like. To keep the style consistent with all the other tutorials, I'm still going to assign only one color to all the elements that you see here. However, I'm going to keep them separate here. So if I would like to go back to have different shaders for different elements, then I can totally do that. But first, I'm going to unhide the table again. And I'm going to rearrange the protein. So let's go into the top view, move it a bit to the front and a bit to the side, back into camera view by hitting 0. And then I'm just going to enlarge it a bit. And I'm also going to do some kind of rotation to find a nice orientation on how it's going to sit on our table. Looks nice. Then I'm going to go into the front view by just hitting 1, and I'm going to select the plane that has our wood material, just to check if some parts of my structure are actually penetrating the plane. Some of them do, so you see there is a loop that is penetrating, so I'm going to turn my structure a bit in the Y direction to have it something like that, and move it up a bit. I think in that case it would not have been visible anyway, but still we try to keep everything consistent. Good. Then I'm going to assign the materials now first to my cofactor. So I'm going to stay with the principled material, but I would like to have everything nice and shiny and a bit of a pinkish tone for my oxygen. For the carbon atoms, I'm going to assign a different material. So I'm going to use glass in that case, in combination with an emission shader. And I'm going to turn down the roughness of the glass a bit. And, oops, I selected the wrong shader, emission, and the emission value up so that it's a bit lighter. For the nitrogen, I'm going to go for a softer blue, but a bit brighter, and also make it glossy. For the phosphate, I'm going to do the same. I'm going to decrease the roughness to have it nice and shiny, and since it's covered in the back anyways, I'm going to leave it like that. For the helices and all the other structural elements, I'm going to go for the same color, which is going to be a dark gray. So I'm going to make everything white and just turn down the amount of color and make it shiny as well. And instead of reselecting or readjusting the color here, we can go ahead and select the helix color from our list for every different element. Of course, now the element is renamed to helix, but that is fine. You could choose a different name again, so you could go back to loop and sheet and so on and so forth, so that would not be a problem. Good, so that would be the final outcome. I'm still not really happy with the alignment, to be honest, because the cofactor is not nicely visible, so I'm going to turn it a bit and move it a bit down. Probably I can increase it a bit as well. Go into front view, and obviously I moved it down too much. Still a bit up. Yeah. So that would be the final look of our protein that we imported from VMD. Good, so I'm going to give that a final render now, and I'm going to come back as soon as that image is rendered, and then let's have a look to the final outcome. See you in a couple of seconds. So my version is finished now, and that would be the final outcome. Very comparable to all the other imported objects from Bimol, Chimera, or Yasara. So that concludes the section of importing your object from different supporting software. As I said before, go ahead, choose the software that you are used to. In another short tutorial, I would like to introduce an add-on to you that is made to serve as a gateway between Bimol, VMD, and Blender. So if you're interested in that, go check the next tutorial. So see you later.